as we continue with all of the Mr. Pandaria heroics. We're jumping into one of the new ones. It is a dungeon that you can obviously do around about level 85. You're going to get access to the Storm Stout Brewery. It's really cool. I love this dungeon. It was actually my favourite dungeon out of the two over Temple of the Jade Serpent that we went into. I actually really enjoyed this one. It has great pacing on normal mode. All the bosses were kind of unique and interesting. It was all pretty cool. This first pull, in fact, is the first trash that you go to. I was actually a little bit worried about here. This trash as a way of insta-giving the tanks. It actually felt that in heroic mode, it didn't do as much damage or wasn't as dangerous as it was on normal mode. Check those heroic leaps out. Oh, what up? Absolutely love it. But overall, this trash actually felt kind of nice. Like I said, this is one of the dungeons I really did enjoy in normal mode. I was hoping to see a lot of this stuff expanded on in the heroic version. Could we get some new mechanics and all that kind of stuff? But we'll get there. While I just absolutely tear it up with the best AoE pull you have ever seen, no aggro for anyone else, and some large numbers. Oh, Prot Warriors rejoice. Absolutely fantastic. Had a great time running this dungeon. Actually did it very, very smoothly. But of course, then we're going to fight our first boss, Ook Ook. Ook Ook obviously has some very interesting mechanics. We've got the barrels floating around, which the DPSers need to pick up, and the healers, and roll them into Ook Ook himself. That is going to give him a nice big damage buff. You will notice there's a Warlock here. There's me giving the big words. Can you turn off your Voidwalker? I believe that I came in on the second trash pull, and the guys had literally had a little bit of a trouble with a previous tank and used a Voidwalker. Unfortunately, the Warlock did refuse to turn that Voidwalker off, making my life a little bit harder. Never mind. We'll let it slide. But Ook Ook himself, he doesn't exactly have particularly high melee damage. He's very nice. It does allow the other characters to run around the dungeon, pick up some barrels, get them rolled into him, and do some big damage. The complaint about this one is very similar to the other Mr. Pandaria ones. It is very difficult to die to Ook Ook. Ook Ook doesn't have many ways of actually killing you unless you are completely silly and hurt yourself with the barrels taking massive amounts of extra damage. Then you're in danger of dying, but that is a serious mistake if you're going down that road. You're in serious trouble without anything trying to help you. Ook Ook doesn't have much of anything. It's all about how much DPS can you pull off. I'm sure at some point we're going to see some people doing crazy amounts of damage once they coordinate to get all the barrels rolled onto him at once. This issue could actually use with more emphasis. What I would like to see is Ook Ook have a shield that needs barrels rolled into him, then he takes extreme damage, and he's literally invulnerable until he takes that amount of barrels. Similar to the Curator in Karazhan. The reason being, as you can see, many DPSers actually just completely ignore the barrels. They don't understand the purpose of the barrels, and you'll generally have one person who's the baller of the group who will be doing all the barrels on his own, pretty much, maybe second person. This fight has been out for a while. We would like to see that. I think if he went invulnerable until a certain amount of barrels had hit him, forcing people to actually take part in that encounter, because it's a lot of fun. Rolling on the barrels is a lot of fun. It's a nice distraction. It's a nice change. It's a nice mechanic. I would just like to see Ook Ook needs to be super drunk. Maybe we're rolling beer into him until his shield drops, and then he takes an increased amount of damage for a big Zerg. I think that would be slightly more fun. And plus allow the better groups to get better control over it. And Pugs just to learn a little something about different mechanics instead of standing there and just DPSing the big red bar. Optalius rolls in. He's a gangster, but again, no new mechanics whatsoever from the normal mode. His mechanics are exactly the same. You can see I was holding off there as we were missing a part of the group, a fourth member. But the guys went ahead and pulled Optalius anyway. He's exactly the same as he is on normal mode. No new mechanics to speak of, which I am a little bit sad about. I want to heroic to have extra stuff going on. One extra mechanic, similar to what we see in the raid dungeons. If there's another boss, then we tend to have a different mechanic in heroic that is new and featured to that heroic dungeon. That does not happen with Hoptalius, and so far it hasn't happened with many bosses at all, to be honest. We haven't seen any new mechanics, so it's not surprising, it's disappointing. That's all it is. It's a little disappointing. But overall, this fight is fantastic. So much going on. We've got adds to control, we've got big hammers to use, we've got spear and carrot breaths, and in general, this entire instance is a load of fun. Obviously, based on beer. All the crazy stuff like crazy beer-infused rabbits. Absolutely hilarious dungeon. Really well designed. Would love to have seen one new mechanic. One new mechanic. Perhaps two Hoptaliuses on different timers. That would have been a lot of fun. So we could have had not as easy to avoid this whirlwind. Maybe he just split himself in half. He had a drunken haze version of him. So stuff like that. Two carrot breaths going on. More to avoid. A little bit more interest going on. I think that would be absolutely cool. Similar to Morchok. I would like to have seen a bit of a Morchok mechanic in here. Hoptalius goes ahead, splits himself in two, get an extra little fight out of Hoptalius. I think that would have been really cool. I would like Blizzard to have done that. Other than that, he has a lot of HP. a hell of a lot of HP, but if you've got a decent tank, you're going to be able to control all the adds really easily. You can see no adds running around whatsoever. Stunning them down, shockwaving them down, letting the DPS do their thing. Absolutely fine. But his mechanics are cool. He's a very, very cool boss. Very cool boss. Very funny. You can't argue that the idea of a crazy beer-infused rabbit is in fact hilarious. It is. It's a great idea by Blizzard's put in. I actually love about this dungeon is that the elementals are called beer ale-mentals. They are elementals of the beer world. Very clever little play on words by Blizzard there. But I thoroughly enjoyed it. Thoroughly enjoyed it. It's got a lot of HP, as you can see. Pretty fun. Lots going on. I like it. Three or four different mechanics going on. Good, good rating for Hoptalius. And it's a shame that we have to kill him. Again, he just needed a little bit more. He can die on this fight. You can die. I have seen people die on this, but it generally comes down to ad control and people standing on the explosive rabbits when they land. If you can get through that mechanic by using the hammers, then you're in no problem whatsoever. Moving on to the last room. Now, this boss is incredibly long. It needs a phase removing, as far as I'm concerned. You have three phases to this fight. One is going to be two elementals, then a break period, then four elementals. Then we're actually going to get to see the boss, which is Yanzu the Uncasked. If you're not sure what's going on here, you've got a guy in the corner, a little monk dude, who is trying to brew the perfect beer. And these are all the side effects of him brewing that perfect beer. So before we even reach Yanzu the Uncasked, we're going to have to fight quite a few waves of these little elementals. These things really hurt, and they're also going to put the debuff on you, the beer debuff, where you'll get six stacks that can only be removed by moving around. You can see I'm hopping around left and right, clearing these stacks. If you reach a certain amount of stacks, you will get stunned. You'll become insanely drunk and stunned on the floor, and you will die. They have a very, very large melee range. You can see the healer barely keeps up with the damage on this fight at all. Everybody's having to move around. It's actually a really, really cool little fight. These two on their own is almost a boss fight in itself. You can see the group is struggling immensely. That is down to some people not realizing you can clear the debuff. You can see they've all pretty much got the debuff there. One man goes down. So you can die to this fight. This is cool. Unfortunately, you're not exactly punished for it. In between the phases, you do actually get out of combat. You become completely out of combat. You can drink, you can res, you can do all those kind of things. You want to be punished a little bit more for not dealing with the debuff. Yes, you did not deal with the debuff. I would like to see probably a wipe there saying, yo, dude, you need to clear that debuff. You just need to run around. You need to do something along those lines just to clear yourself of that debuff. While he reses up, we've got the phase breaker. As you can see, he managed to get a full resurrection off there of the priest. He's then going to go ahead and heal that guy up and get the party ready for phase two. So it's essentially a trash pack. I would like to have seen us kept in combat so it actually punishes us from the start. If you're going to put a large, lengthy boss fight in, I understand Blizzard's point of view is if they make a large, lengthy boss fight and people can die, which is unlikely to happen in most of the Mr. Pandaria heroics, then they want a break period in there while people readjust and get themselves back together. They don't want it to be too stressful on new players. However, this is heroics. Someone told me as well they're thinking of removing the name heroic from these dungeons because they realize they are in fact pretty easy. I've yet to see a source on that, but I wouldn't be too disbelieving that is the case, is that they're going to change them to just a different name and take the heroic level off them. The word heroic does imply some high level of difficulty. It does not really apply so far. These mobs are kind of a pain in the ass for the tank. You're very tempted to find a way to actually move them. Now, moving them is extremely difficult. They do cast, as you can see there. And if you do manage to pull off an interrupt like I just did, you can move them briefly before they start recasting. Ideally, I want to find a way, and I'll be doing this on my personal time, is how we can gather these mobs into one position using disrupting shout and pummel and all that kind of good stuff that warriors have access to. And try and create a death ball so we can quickly AoE these down. If you're not aware of this mechanic though, ballers, don't stand outside of this square while DPSing these adds. If you stand near them, you will gain a buff that increases your mana regen. It's actually what you're supposed to do to refresh. You're not supposed to stand on the side and get out of combat and drink. You're actually supposed to just stand in here, get yourself the buff, and get some big mana regen, and you will be full health, full mana again. These are far too much health, however. Far, far too much health. Look how long it takes to kill these. Absolutely shocking amount of health. They need reducing probably by half. If we're going to kill, I think it's 3, 6, 9, 12 of these adds, we need to reduce the HP on them. 12 adds is fine, but their health is so big and they are so spread out to avoid big AoE. We just need to reduce those health down, Blizz. Let's get them cut in half, probably. Get them wiped out. Get ourselves some healing regen and all that stuff, and then we're good to go for the next phase. So coming into phase two, our brewmaster on the right-hand side is in fact going to screw up again, and he's tried a new concoction. This has then spawned these four ads. They're going to come in there and be a little bit gangster. Now, these ones have very, very little melee damage whatsoever. In fact, they're just going to do very little of anything. Nothing much to worry about here whatsoever for anybody in the group. You can't really die to these. Even with all four of them, you're not going to struggle for HP. I put down the skull banner. Let's get some big DPS around. They will drop the deep damage pool on the floor. Just move them around. No big deal whatsoever. This phase could be skipped. This is what I'm talking about. For a long fight, this phase could just go ahead and be skipped. It's not really necessary. It doesn't add anything to the fight other than waiting to actually get to the last boss, Yanzu. And Yanzu himself has an incredible amount of mechanics to throw in there. We don't need this phase. The first two and then the break period before the main boss, I think, will be perfectly fine. The first two are quite dangerous. These two are damage for damage's sake. Just killing a health bar. Not that fun. It can be removed entirely and nobody would miss it. It's just going to be an extended boss fight. This could be one of those fights where, one of these dungeons where eventually somewhere in the Mists of Pandaria, people will be going, I don't really want to do Storm Stout. The last boss is far too long. Not that fun. But eventually we do pick up Yanzu. There he is, that little gangster, that big ale mental. Now, Yanzu has a selection of abilities that are all going to change depending on when you fight him. He has all sorts of stuff. He has bubbles on the floor. A few things will remain the same throughout the fight. Sometimes you'll spawn adds that heal him. People will never ever change to kill them, unfortunately, and we'll see evidence of that in this video. You are still going to get the debuff that stacks up, the stacking beer debuff. You need to keep moving, or if you're melee, you can simply just jump up and down while you're traveling in the air. The debuff will clear naturally. I discover that later on. As you can see, these adds spawn. I instantly switch. Now, Yanzu will not change position, so tanks, you need to be careful. I notice this straight away. If you move away from Yanzu, he will literally attack the next melee person. He will not move. You've got to watch out for this beer coming along the floor. These beer lines, they stun you. As you can see, I got caught by the trailed edge of one of them, and you are stunned for several seconds. Very dangerous as a tank to be stunned, obviously. You don't want that to happen. The ideal position you want to be in is actually in the center of the room where both of the lines cross. One jump will, in fact, nullify both of those beer traveling lines, and we try and pull that off as many times as humanly possible. As you can see, Yanzu doesn't have much health. You can take him down to half health, but ignoring these adds and trying to zerg him is a very, very bad thing. You can see I moved to the middle there, jumping over both lines simultaneously. That's what you want to be doing. I eventually just have to ignore Yanzu. I'm trying to get them in some sort of close range so I can continue to tank Yanzu while the DPS is completely ignored. You can see his health hasn't moved at all, and that's because his healing is just being, his DPS is being completely nullified by all these adds. Eventually, I will tell the party, please, God, DPS the adds. We need to get this done. I'm dragging them into a death ball. You can get a ton of AoE done, guys. Get it done. More beer lines. You can clear them with two jumps, as you can see there. But as a caster, that is going to be a DPS loss. You don't want that completely. There I go, dropping my demo banner, keeping that down there so people can, in fact, take less damage while all this is going on. I'm trying to get the guys to kill the adds. Please kill the adds, because Yanzu is now back to full health, I believe. Ignoring these adds is a huge no-no. As soon as you see adds, and as soon as you see that the DPSs are slacking on these adds, get in there and start shouting those names. Get DPSing the adds. Otherwise, look, Yanzu back to completely full health. Completely full health. These adds have been ignored for so long. Trying to interrupt them as much as humanly possible. Trying to help out the group. Eventually, the adds will go down, and then you straight into the big DPS on Yanzu. And all you're worried about in this particular instance is clearing your beer debuff so you no longer get stunned. Other mechanics that this guy could do, like I say, he has a selection of mechanics, and it will change depending on when you pull him. He has a choice of mechanics he can use, which is really cool because it's always different. Sometimes he will have carbonation, where he's going to fill the floor with carbonated beer. You have to take in a bubble. You have to click a bubble. Bubbles will appear. Large carbonated bubbles will appear on the floor. And then you can literally dive in the bubble. You'll become able to fly around the room, fly well above these suds on the floor, the carbonated floor, and then start DPSing him again. He will also spawn bubbles around himself, beer bubbles around him. You need to kill them first. He will become completely immune to damage while these bubbles are up. They're similar to a bubble shield, essentially. And you want to make sure that you DPS those down very, very quickly and get on with the fight. It's perfectly possible to kill this fight extremely quickly. As you can see, he does not have a great deal of health. But if you do it wrong, it will turn into an extensively long fight. Unnecessarily long. Destroy those adds, guys. They're the only things that really heal him up. Other than that, it's all about avoiding stuff. Avoid the beer floor. Avoid the big stun from getting the beer debuff. keep jumping in the air. I literally just turned to jumping. You can see I got tail end of the bear trail again. Got stunned. Very dangerous. Look at my health dropping very, very low now. In fact, my healer is completely Time to start spamming that victory rush. There you go. Victory rushing myself. If you can't heal me, buddy, I'm just going to heal my damn self. Don't you worry about it. I've got this. Preacher's in charge. We're not going to die to this guy. So your risk of dying to this fight is literally if you screw it up and you ignore the ads for too long. As you can see, we've worn the healer out of mana. We left it far too long. This fight should have been done over long ago. Overall, I score the Stormstout Brewery Heroic 7 out of 10. I think it's pretty good. It loses points for not having any new mechanics. No new mechanics whatsoever is a huge no-no when we jump into Heroic. We want to see something new and interesting. Each boss should have some sort of alteration to it. But it's new, it's fresh, it's got great pacing, the trash doesn't take too long, there's nice three bosses in there, decent loot, 7 out of 10, no problems at all. Only change I recommend is cutting the HP a little bit. Take it easy, ballers.